Hey everyone, I'm Ellen here at eTrailer.com. Today we're taking a look at the Pacer Performance Hi-5 LED Truck Cab Light Kit. This is styled after the 1999 through 2014 Ford factory roof lights. And basically what this kit is going to do is give you that Hi-5 cab look, so we'll have that kind of big rig look on our truck with the addition of these 5 lights on the top of our cab. The other benefit with that, besides just looking cool, is that it's going to actually improve our visibility out on the road, at least for other drivers seeing us coming down the road, especially in inclement weather. If you're in an area or driving through an area where there's a lot of rain, mist, fog, snow, anything like that, it helps other drivers to see you coming down the way. So those are going to be pretty much the benefits there. The nice thing about this kit is that it pretty much comes with everything we need to get this installed. Of course, we have our 5 lights. It has 2 studs already installed on each of those lights with a little gasket there to make sure that everything stays nice and sealed up. And then we'll also have the hardware to get those attached. So you do have to drill through your cab into, drill through your roof into the cab of your truck, and then you'll have to drop the headliner down so you can get access to the bottom of those studs to attach the hardware. Of course, you want one washer on the top, another washer on the bottom, so you're kind of sandwiching that metal in between the two, and then the nut on the backside. It comes with our LED bulbs. It also still comes with the incandescents, just in case you ever want to switch them out. You probably will never need these unless you want to use them for something else. It uses the 194 type bulbs, which are pretty common. These are going to be the T10 194 bulbs. So you can use them in all kinds of stuff, maybe an interior light or a side marker light on your vehicle. So not necessarily something you'd want to throw away, but I would definitely use the LEDs instead. They're going to be longer lasting, typically a little bit brighter, and have less power draw from your battery. Now, to get these in place, it does come with these little sockets to hold the wire, or to hold the light in our light, or hold the bulb in our light. And you just have to push it into place. The little tines inside there might be a little bit tight, so you just have to kind of coax it in place. It is polarity sensitive, so if it doesn't turn on at first, you might just need to take it out and turn it the other way. So I'm going to pop this in place so you can see how bright these are. So we'll have our red wire coming off of there. That's going to go to our power connection. And then the little black wire with the ring terminal on it, that goes to our ground connection. Turn our light on here. And as you can see, nothing. So I'll turn this off, undo it, take my bulb out, and flip it around. Try it again. And this is definitely something that you'll want to do before you actually get it installed, so that you're not having to try to take everything apart once you plug everything in. But now you can see that light comes on. So it's not going to light up the night or anything. It's just going to help to give us, again, that extra visibility for other drivers to see us and just add a little bit to the looks of our truck. Comes with all 5 of those LED bulbs and the sockets, as well as a length of wire and a fuse to go in line with our switch. So you can run this separate from your lighting system in your truck. You don't have to worry about tapping into any factory wires, avoiding any warranties that way. You'll just turn this on and off separately from everything else. Of course, if you want to tap it into your running lights, you can. It's just maybe, especially on a newer truck, something that would potentially void your warranty. So something that you want for your truck. So you probably want to be aware of that. It also comes with the quick splice connectors. And normally we would suggest switching these out for a heat shrink or a regular insulated butt connector. But with this installed, kind of the way that it's designed, that you have this one wire that's going to go between all 5 of your lights, and then each of the connections going in between there, these are going to actually work out okay. They're going to be inside your vehicle, so you don't really have to worry about any kind of water protection. It's already going to be in on the interior. And as long as you get a really good crimp on these and make sure that the little catch holds really well, you shouldn't have any issues. So you should be okay using those. The 2 little screws are going to help you get the switch actually attached. in place. So pretty much everything you need there, with the gasket on the bottom of each of our lights. You shouldn't have to worry about any water getting into the cab. If you want to throw a little bit of gasket sealant around each of those holes as you drill through your cab, not a bad idea. You can pick some up here at eTrailer.com. You will have to make 3 holes in your truck per light. So that'll be a total of 15, one for each of the studs, and then an additional hole for the wiring to go through. So pretty complete kit, gives us everything that we really need to get our lights on our truck. It does meet SAE specifications as far as the size of each of our lights. Let's measure them here. So it's going to be about 3 inches long, or excuse me, 3 inches wide by 4 inches long, and about 1 3/4 inches tall. It's kind of hard to gauge that one since it's kind of curved there, but about 1 3/4 inches. And that's going to be the same for each of our lights. But that's pretty much going to do it for our look at the Pacer Performance Hi-5 LED Truck Cab Light Kit. There are a couple other configurations available with smoke or clear lights if you want to look at those as well. Thanks for watching.